Hi there and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base channel. My name is Isha and in this video, we'll take a look at how to upgrade an Umbraco 9 cloud project to Umbraco 10. Before we jump in, let's take a quick look at what we're going to do in this video. First off, we'll take a look at the prerequisites. After which, we'll enable .NET 6 on the cloud portal for each environment of the cloud project. Then, we'll clone down our project from cloud to our local system. Following which, we'll upgrade the project locally using Visual Studio. And finally, we'll deploy the changes from local to cloud and verify the upgrade on the cloud portal. Sounds like a lot, right? Don't worry, I'll walk you through the steps. First, we'll take a look at the prerequisites. To upgrade your cloud project, we recommend upgrading your current cloud project to the latest version of Umbraco 9 with at least two environments and a backup of your Umbraco 9 project database. Once you've taken the backup of the project database, we'll move on to the next step, that is enabling .NET 6 on the cloud portal for each environment of the cloud project. On the cloud portal, go to the project you wish to upgrade. I'll select the Upgrade v9 to v10 demo project. As you can see, I'm using the latest versions of Umbraco CMS, Deploy and Forms. Let's go to Settings and click on Advanced. Scroll down to Runtime Settings and enable .NET 6 for your Umbraco 9 install for each environment of your cloud project if it's not enabled. Once you've done this, it's time to move on to the next step, that is cloning down your project locally. Now, we'll go back to our project and clone the project to our local system. So we'll go to the development environment, copy this URL, and go to the folder where we want to clone it. I'll create a new folder, give it a name. And now, using a Git client, I'll type git clone and the Git URL that I just copied from the cloud portal. You can use any Git client of your choice. We'll navigate to the project file and open it in Visual Studio. We recommend building and running the project locally so you can resolve any errors before upgrading the project. Make sure you log into the back office to ensure your content is intact. So we'll log into the back office and we'll take a look at the version and it says 9.5.1. We'll now take a look at our content and looks like our content is restored. We'll go to the media section and we have our media folders in place. And looking at the doc types and templates, looks like everything is as it should be. So let's close this down and move on to upgrading our project locally. Let's begin with updating the .NET target framework from .NET 5.0 to .NET 6.0. To do so, we'll right-click on the project and select Properties. From the Target Framework drop-down, we'll select .NET 6.0 and save it. This change is reflected in the project file. We also need to ensure the packages we are using are available in Umbraco 10. To do so, we'll go to Tools, NuGet Package Manager and select Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. Here, we'll go to the Browse tab and look for Microsoft Extensions Dependency Injection Abstractions package. Select the project, choose version 6 from the drop-down and install it. Next, I'll go to the Install tab and upgrade Umbraco.cms to version 10. You can find the list of packages and their versions in our documentation. I'll upgrade the rest of the packages and be back. Once the package versions are upgraded, we'll move on to the program.cs file. We'll update this file with configure Umbraco defaults and webbuilder.useStaticWebAssets. Both these calls are new. You can find the code snippets in our documentation. Cool. We'll now update the schema reference in the appsettings.json file. Similarly, we'll update the environment-specific appsettings.json files. Cool. Remember to save your changes. And finally, we need to delete a couple of folders from the project. So we'll go back to the project folder, go to the www root folder, and delete the Umbraco folder. We'll go back and go to the Umbraco folder and delete the partial view macros, Umbraco back office, Umbraco install, and Umbraco website folder. In the config folder, we'll delete the language folder. We'll go back and go to the app plugins and delete the Umbraco forms folder if you're using Umbraco forms in your project. And that was all the changes that we needed to do. We'll now build and run the project locally and verify if our project has been upgraded to Umbraco 10. I'll go to the back office and sign in with my Umbraco ID. Let's take a look at the version. And there it is. Our project is now upgraded to Umbraco version 10. Let's take a quick look at the content section, media section, and settings section to ensure that the upgrade has not affected our files. Cool. Everything looks great. Now, the only thing left to do is deploy and test it on Umbraco Cloud. So let's go ahead and do that. Before we deploy our changes to cloud, we need to delete the folders from the cloud project which we just deleted from our local project. If you don't delete it, you might end up with failed deployment or collision errors. Let's go to the development environment of the project and access Kudu to delete these folders. We'll go to Debug Console, CMD. Go to the site folder, that's where your project is stored. And we have to delete the folders from both the repository and the www root folder. So in the repository, we'll navigate to Source, Umbraco Project, App Plugins, and delete the Umbraco Forms folder. You can ignore the error message. We'll go back and go to the Umbraco folder and delete the Partial View Macros folder, Umbraco Back Office folder, Umbraco Install folder, and the Umbraco website folder. In the config folder, we'll delete the language folder. I'll close these error messages. And we'll go back. We'll go to the www root folder and delete the Umbraco folder. This will take some time, so I'll forward it to once it's done. Similarly, we'll delete the same set of folders from the www root folder as well. I will forward this part a little bit. The only difference in this is that there's another www root folder within which there's an Umbraco folder that you need to delete. Cool. Now that we've deleted the folders from both the repository and the www root folders, it's time to deploy our changes from local to cloud. We'll go to the Umbraco project folder and using a Git client of your choice, you can deploy the changes to cloud. I'm using Git Bash here. I'll first run the git status command. And now I'll add my files and commit these files to the repository with the message upgraded project from v9 to v10. And now push these files to the repository. This will take some time, so I'll fast forward it to once it's done. Now that the changes have been deployed to cloud, let's take a look at our cloud portal. Let's refresh the page. And there it is. We've successfully upgraded our project to version 10. Let's view the page of this environment, and it looks fine. Let's go to the back office and take a look at the version number. And the project is upgraded to version 10. Let's quickly take a look at the content, media, and settings section. Cool. These look good. They don't seem to be affected by the upgrade. The only thing left to do is to deploy these changes to the live environment. But before you do that, remember to access Kudu for the live environment and delete the folders from the repository and the www root folder. And that's it for this video. To summarize, we enabled .NET 6 on the cloud portal for each environment of the cloud project. We cloned down our project from cloud to our local system. Then we upgraded the project locally using Visual Studio. And finally, we deployed the changes from local to cloud and verified the upgrade on the cloud portal. Hope you found this video useful. Until next time.